Space, the final frontier. These are the voyages of the starship Enterprise. Its five-year mission, to explore strange new worlds, to seek out new life and new civilizations, to boldly go where no man has gone before.
First premiering on NBC on September 8th, 1966, few television shows have had such a lasting impact on both the medium of television and society as a whole as Star Trek. Created by Gene Roddenberry, the show presented an optimistic future of cooperation and exploration. Star Trek, the original series, was a new frontier in history, revolutionizing science fiction and television, and breaking social norms in mass media. Star Trek was the brainchild of television writer and producer Gene Roddenberry. Born in El Paso, Texas, in August of 1921, Eugene Wesley Roddenberry served as a B-19 pilot in the 394th Bomb Squadron in World War II, flying an estimated 89 combat missions. Following the war, Roddenberry worked as a commercial airline pilot and as a police officer, before becoming a full-time television writer in 1956. During this time, Roddenberry wrote numerous scripts for network television westerns, including Jefferson Drum, Bat Matterson, and Have Gun, Will Travel, for which he won a Writers Guild Award. In 1963, Roddenberry created The Lieutenant, a show documenting the fictional lives of Marines at Camp Pendleton in Southern California. Here, Roddenberry would first meet and work with numerous actors who would later appear on Star Trek, including Leonard Nimoy, Nichelle Nichols, and Walter Koenig. Though the series was successful, it was canceled after its first season, partly due to Roddenberry and partners at the Department of Defense having a disagreement regarding a storyline involving a white man and a black man finding common cause serving in the Marines.
Lieutenant, I can't help you talk with Ernie, but he's intelligent. He'll understand the full meaning of every word and sentence you use. Only I don't know what you're going to tell him. He's been a Negro a lot longer than you've been thinking about his problem.
With the success of The Lieutenant behind him, Roddenberry shifted his focus to a previously scrapped idea, an interracial crew traveling around the world on an airship. Changing elements to better fit the science fiction genre, Roddenberry would soon send 3 copies of a pitch and $2 to the Writers Guild of America, officially registering Star Trek in March of 1964.
He felt that television was a potent medium that was being wasted with the kind of pap that we had on television at that time. He felt that, yes, television can be entertaining, but it can also be intellectually engaging. He felt that it can be informative, it can be educational, and it can even inspire.
Desilu Production Company, headed by Desi Arnaz and Lucille Ball, picked up Roddenberry's script and helped secure funding from NBC for a pilot. Work began quickly, with Roddenberry's first pilot pitched to NBC in November of 1964. However, the pilot, which featured a Starship Enterprise headed by Captain Pike, failed to impress executives. Another pilot was ordered, with Roddenberry and Desilu making major adjustments to the cast and tone. This new pilot impressed executives, and in February of 1966, NBC officially picked up Star Trek, adding it to the fall 1966 catalog.
Captain's log, stardate 1513.1. Our position, orbiting planet M113. On board the Enterprise, Mr. Spock, temporarily in command. On the planet, the ruins of an ancient and long-dead civilization.
Backdrop by the Vietnam War and the peak of the civil rights movement, Star Trek first premiered on September 8, 1966, on the eve of the Gemini 11th launch. Millions of viewers tuned in to watch what would be the first of dozens of adventures, starring the cast of the Starship Enterprise. The show was one of the first American science fiction shows to feature a recurring cast, with each hour-long episode featuring a different adventure for the crew. Leading the ship was Captain James Kirk, an intelligent and sometimes rash officer with much experience, played by William Shatner. The show also starred Leonard Nimoy as the half-alien, half-human Spock, the ship's science officer, and DeForest Kelly as Dr. Leonard Bones McCoy, the ship's chief medical officer, While the adventures of the USS Enterprise entertained and thrilled viewers, they also carried a deeper meaning.
You know, so there was all this turbulence in the 60s and early 70s, and none of it was being reflected on television. None of it was being commented on in television. Even so-called science fiction, Lost in Space, was really a fantasy in space, you know. And so what Gene did was he used science fiction as a metaphor to comment on these issues, civil rights, or the Vietnam War and the conflict between groups of people based on ideas about war and peace, the cultural challenge to our society with the hippie movement. They were all commented on by Star Trek. In almost every episode, there was some commentary made on these issues.
One of the ways Gene Roddenberry commented on society was the inclusion of a pluralistic cast. In addition to William Shatner, Leonard Nimoy, and DeForest Kelly, the show featured Nichelle Nichols as communications officer Lieutenant Nyota Uhura, George Takei as helmsman Lieutenant Hakuru Sulu, and in seasons 2 and 3, Walter Koenig as navigator Pavel Chekhov. Star Trek not only featured one of the most diverse casts ever seen by audiences in the 1960s, but was unique in how it accurately presented minorities as equals in both ability and position, a new frontier for representation in media.
Dr. Martin Luther King, my leader, is walking toward me, not 10 feet away. And then this man says, "My family are your greatest fans. As a matter of fact, this is the only show on television that my wife, Coretta, and I will allow our little children to watch." I just looked at him. He said, "For the first time on television, we will be seen as we should be seen every day, as intelligent, quality, beautiful people who can sing, dance, and but who can go into space, who can be lawyers, who can be teachers, who can be professors, who are in this day, and yet you don't see it on television until now."
Star Trek was a new frontier in many other ways as well. The inclusion of Russian officer Pavel Chekhov offered an optimistic view of a future where America and the Soviet Union could put aside their differences and become allies, an unthinkable thought during the height of the Cold War. Additionally, Star Trek was a new frontier in technology, with devices appearing in the show later inspiring the development of cell phones, 3D printers, and digital assistants.
Library computer.
History files.
Star Trek also included the first scripted kiss between an actor of African descent and an actor of European descent on American television, with William Shatner's Captain Kirk kissing Nichelle Nichols' Lieutenant Uhura in the season 3 episode Plato's Stepchildren. Though beloved by many fans, poor ratings in the third season led NBC to consider canceling Star Trek in 1969. A letter-writing campaign was organized to persuade the studio not to, with over 600 letters a week arriving at NBC during the campaign's peak. However, the efforts to save the show were ultimately unsuccessful, with NBC canceling Star Trek in February of 1969, and the final episode airing on Tuesday, June 3rd of that year. In later years, Star Trek would find success and a larger audience through syndication, quickly becoming a cult classic. In 1973, Paramount Studios produced Star Trek, the animated series, featuring the cast of the original show. Thanks to another letter-writing campaign, NASA named the first orbiter space shuttle the Enterprise in 1976. Later that decade, Paramount also began producing a series of films based on the show, beginning with Star Trek The Motion Picture, which premiered on December 7th, 1979. To this date, new Star Trek series and films are still in development, with no signs of slowing down anytime soon. Star Trek, the original series, was a new frontier in history, revolutionizing science fiction and television, and breaking social norms in mass media, leaving a lasting effect on society and culture.